Your spot lit for everybody now.
All right, hold on, there we go. All right, hi everyone, my name is Susan Cato Chapman. As Kathy said, I teach at Appalachian State University in Boone, North Carolina. I'm here to walk you through an exercise of the four brothers. I wanna tell you a little bit about how the lesson is gonna go, and then we will just jump in. We are going to start with talking about just a short explanation about what the four brothers are. Through this, I'm going to use some images of nature. We use a lot of nature in Chekhov. We use a lot of nature. So I invite you, when you're kind of taking this information in, to look at the way the forms move. Look at what sensations come to you when you see these images. And then I'm going to, this is the heady part, just the talking about what, the four brothers are. And I pulled it directly from To the Actor, Michael Chekhov's text. So, the words are from him as a clear explanation about what the four brothers are and what he really meant, and able to use them in our work. Then I'm going to take you into Crossing the Threshold. If you were with us on Monday, you were privy to a really great explanation and leading with Lionel Walsh and Kathy Albers. I'm going to take a little bit of what they did because it really inspired me, and I'm going to use it to help you cross the threshold. And if you've never done this before, it's okay. I will absolutely take you through this process. One of the things, though, before we go into what else we're going to do, there was a great, I saw an interview with Leslie Odom Jr. the other day. He was talking on the Today Show about Hamilton, blah, 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 and it occurred to me that everyone crosses the threshold, whether we realize it or not. The language he used was kind of cool, though. He said, they asked, like, what's the one song you enjoy doing, or blah, 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 and he kind of abandoned the thing. He goes, you know, when I step onto stage, it's the first few notes that really mean something, and once I do that, once I find that authentic place, I know that everything else is going to fall into place for the rest of the show. And I looked at my wife, and I said, oh my God, he's crossing the threshold and entering into the actor's ideal center. And we both laughed, but that's it. It's crossing the threshold into an understanding of you're going into the higher ego. You're going into this place, this creative place where you know where you're going, and it's beautiful, and it's organic, and it's creative. So that, in a nutshell, is kind of a new way of me thinking about crossing the threshold. So that's what we're going to do. Something I need you to do right now is I need you to look around you and find three or four objects that you can pick up, move, play with. You're going to be using these objects to help you find the four brothers. So, for instance, I'm take my kid's toy and I'm be able to move it through space around me and explore. Don't think too hard about what the objects are. Just find something that you feel comfortable picking up. So how this is going to go is I've actually created a video of me working through the process. And what it is I'm going to explore the three objects with you, or four objects with you, into space. You'll see me moving with space, and I'll side coach you through that. And then I've created a piece of music that's just going to play. And I want you to use that time to really explore on your own. I think one of the great things is the idea of us being on Zoom is you can kind of move like you've always wanted, like no one's watching, right? But we are actors, and we are trying to embrace the feeling of the whole. So even when you are working on your own, I want you to find that feeling of working with the other people in our that are working with us right now in this Zoom meeting. that will take you through the four. And after that, we will reconvene for spyback. All right, so keep your three or four objects close by. I am now going to attempt to share my screen, although we've rehearsed this. I'm not sure it's going to go. Not yet. All right, let's try this again.
Michael Chekhov believed that in every great piece of art, you will always find four qualities which the artist has put into the creation. These are the feeling of ease, the feeling of form, the feeling of beauty, and the feeling of entirety or wholeness. He also believed that these four qualities must be developed by the actor, that their body and speech must be endowed with these qualities because they're the only instruments available while you're on the stage. He also believed that the body must become a piece of art within itself, that it must acquire these four qualities, and that we must experience them inwardly. As we explore each of the four brothers, I invite you to allow the sensations that you experience to be those of freedom, happiness, and inner warmth. Let all of these feelings fill your entire body, permeating, radiating, and making it more and more alive, more sensitive, and more responsive.
So if you haven't yet, find yourself in a place standing, if you are able. If not, finding in a place where you can sit and be comfortable. And I want you to stand and close your eyes for just a second and just look inwardly. And see if you can acknowledge where you are right now in your emotional space and in your physical space. And you can open your eyes now and invite in the physical space that is around you, the space that you are in. And also think about your creative space. I think as actors, we jump in without really acknowledging where we've come from a lot of times. So take this opportunity just to give yourself the ability and the opportunity to look inward and acknowledge where you are in this moment. Focusing on your breath, a reflexive breath that allows energy to come in and flow out at all times. And in front of you, is a line. You can see it. You can look down. You can see it actually in front of you right now. And behind this line is where we are right now, which is okay. But in front of this line, we don't know what's quite there yet. But we know that it is going to be a creative space for us to do what we need to do in the next 25, 30 minutes. I want you to, in your own time, cross that threshold into the place of the higher ego. Into this creative space where you are ready and willing to explore without judgment and with joy, always with joy. And now I want you to imagine that there's this energy drawing you from the left, and it has a texture. And it has a color. And you grab it, you reach it, and you bring it in. You bring it into your actor's ideal center. And then you look to your right. And you feel the energy drawing you in. And you grab it, and you bring it into your actor's ideal center. And up. Reach, grab it, bring it into your actor's ideal center. You can feel the warmth. You can feel it radiating through your body. And down. Into your actor's ideal center. Forward. Let it radiate. Bring it into your actor's ideal center. And finally, behind you. Bring it into your actor's ideal center. And let that warmth radiate through you, ready to receive and ready to give for this journey that we are about to embark on. Acknowledge. And the radiation. Go ahead and grab your objects as we begin. Focusing on the feeling of ease, find out what that feels like in your body first. What does it feel to move with ease? The understanding of your body in space, with other objects, feeling the alignment of your spine in relation to your head, in relation to the rest of your body. How can you move through the space with ease? And when you feel compelled, you can start to work with objects. And I'll let this movement surprise you. Maybe it's a movement that you never expected yourself to do. And each object has a different weight and a different challenge and a different way of moving in relation to your body. Allow that to happen. Allow breath to be a part of this and always radiate the sensation, whatever you're feeling viscerally in the body. Use the next couple of minutes to explore this.
Thank you.
Now moving into the feeling of form, you can again start with just your body exploration, or you can move into working with objects. And now we're thinking about the feeling of form. Form being, what is my place in the space? How am I engaged with the space, with my object? It's not only what form can I make with the object, but what does that form mean in relation to the space around me? How does someone perceive this? Again, allow your body to just follow your instincts. Don't think too much about planning ahead or how can I create the most interesting form, because your impulse will create that form for you. How does the form of the object change your movement? How does it change your breath? How does it change your awareness of space? As actors, we're called on to be aware of not only our instrument, our bodies, but what's going on around us. So allow yourself to pause at moments and really capture that sensation. What's happening inside your body right now when you focus on form? Into the feeling of beauty. Beauty sometimes can be an elusive concept because we're so used to the aesthetic of what beauty is. But last time I taught this lesson, I was reminded by my instructor, Lavinia Hart, that beauty is like a blossom, that it moves, starting from the in to the out, and radiates, continues radiating. Some things happen that are beautiful and we don't realize it until after the fact. Beauty. What does it mean to have beauty? Some would argue that maybe it is the embodiment of the four brothers. tragedy can be beautiful. So as you move through the space with your objects, I invite you to explore these ideas. What is beauty? How can I use these objects to create something that has beauty? The feeling of beauty. Again, invite the sensations in, allow them to be part of the process so that you can then come back and remember what it felt like. Take a moment, pause if you need to, and breathe in that sensation. Finally, the feeling of wholeness or the entirety. I think during this blessed pandemic, this is the one we've needed the most. So I've started with the gesture of open to invite everything into the space, everything and all of my colleagues and all of my fellow artists who are working and exploring and creating during this process. So as we move into the feeling of the whole or the entirety, there's a great thing to think about, which is the entirety of you as the actor, your body in space, just moving with the most ease that you can. But there's also an entirety of you in relation to the space, meaning what's above you, what's below you. And what is around you from all directions, expanding out into much more than the room that you're in. It is about finding your colleagues, finding the rest of everybody who's on this call right now, who's moving through space and really embracing that feeling of the whole, of the entirety. Can we connect to each other in a moment? So that we are all connected, moving through space, embodying ease, the feeling of form, and the feeling of beauty. Take these next few moments to do that, to see if we can create together. All right, so before joining us back for Spyback, I just want you to take a moment and again acknowledge where you are in this space. A lot of our exploration has been
Michael Chekhov believed that in every great piece of art, you will always find four qualities which the artist has.
Okay, you go away. We have explored full body what it feels like to be in the four brothers, the feeling of ease, the feeling of form, the feeling of beauty, and the feeling of wholeness or the entirety. Take a minute and acknowledge where you are right now in the space. What has changed? Is it your breath? Is it your relationship to the space? Is it relationship to your body? We don't get many opportunities to work full-bodied. So this is a wonderful chance for you to kind of check in with yourself and see how you feel. And with that, I would like to, we've got a lot of time actually for Spyback. So I'd like to invite us to go into Spyback. Spivak is a term that we use in the Chekhov world to talk about what did we do and how do we feel about it. So I think, Kathy, thank you for coming back. I think we're going to open up chat, and Jordan, maybe? Yes. Okay. Hey, Jordan.
Hi. Okay, so everybody, if you want, we're going to utilize the chat again today. Actually, hold on, let me unspotlight you. I can even spotlight myself. We're going to go ahead and use chat today to submit all the questions. That way I can address them as they come in. I will then just feed the question to Susan or Kathy if she's participating as well. And we'll go ahead and do it that way, if that's all right with everybody. So go ahead, utilize that chat. If you cannot locate it, go to the main Zoom window where you see me nice and big. At the very bottom middle will be the chat button, and the little window will appear. Fantastic. I'm already seeing a couple of things. If you'd want to as well, I would invite you to go to your gallery view, where you can view both Kathy and Susan, and me as well if you like, at the same size. It's up to you. I'm going to cancel in case people stay in speaker view. That way, as people speak, they'll show up properly. So let me take a look at the chat really quick. Great. Okay. When exploring the feeling of form, are we making tableaus with our bodies? What exactly is that movement?
Tableaus with your body. It's not something that's static, I would argue. It's something that can have movement, but the understanding that with the movement, there can be a form in the movement. I'm thinking of Chekhov's mold, which I think is what may be confusing, which is that there's a very beginning, very distinct beginning, middle, and end into the movement. This is not mold. This is an opportunity to look at form in your body, form with another object in an abstract way. Kathy, am I on the right path? And
Chekhov says in To the Actor that it's a continuous movement, that it is, when we think about form, the actor sometimes already has something in their mind that they want to accomplish, and that form is the accomplishment of that movement. So it does have a beginning, middle, and an end, but it's continuous. It doesn't stop. And in fact, when we do sculptures, we begin this way at GLMCC with that. I think you explained it really well. Form is never static. It can't be, we can't be frozen in space. Even though that is a form, that form has to move because there's life and energy in the form.
Well, and if I can get a little bit nerdy on you, this is from my Alexander studies. So the idea of there's a term called tensegrity, which is tension and integrity, right? It's a term that comes from architecture, which is the idea that if you build something, that gives them opportunities to move, right? So even if we are here in a form with the Earth's gravitational pull and gravity, we are always moving. It's called postural sway. So, but that's a really technical way of looking at it. But the energetic part of that comes into it too. That even though we're in a form, we're always still moving. Yes. Always.
Yes.
There. Great. I'll go ahead and go on to the next question. Let's see. Do you always go through the four brothers as the self, or do you ever move through them in character?
I love this question. Yes, I think that you do both. I, for today's purposes, I wanted you to move through self, but I think it's important to explore from both points of view. You are the actor, yes, but you're creating a character. So the character ultimately has to go through these moments. One thing I really love about what we did today, and I was thinking about that especially with the Leslie Odom Jr. thing, is the crossing the threshold. You cross the threshold as an actor, but you cross the threshold as a character as well. And I think these are important things to note. And they can have, you as an actor can move through ease, form, the feeling of ease, the feeling of form, the feeling of beauty, the feeling of wholeness, but there's another layer for your character. It's another layer, which is great, because we love to explore. So, you know, we work on our instrument, which is our body, which is us as an actor, so that we can then create the layer for the actor, for the character, rather. Kathy?
No, I think that's a beautiful explanation. You know, on Monday we said that one of the quotes Chekhov has in To the Actor about radiating, receiving, giving and receiving, is that everything that should make an impression upon us as an actor and as a character is what we invite in and we use. So he would say, as Susan just did, yes, as an actor, but another layer is that character, and it's always working inside us that way. It's always multifunctional.
Okay, fabulous. Another question here. I remember you saying that tragedy is beautiful. Could you please elaborate on this idea?
Oh, that which invokes us to feel something that is unique is beautiful. That is the best way I can describe it. Something that takes us to a place we've never been before, that creates so much emotion and feeling is beautiful. Yeah. That's the best way I can describe it.
When we think about Iago, yep, this, yep, character who is, to my way of thinking, kind of an evil guy. But when you watch a gifted actor, you see the beauty in that performance and the beauty of the crafting of the character and the way the actor can express all of that with their form and with ease. And I think that for me, that's the epitome of beauty. It's that authentic behavior to what is given to us. Sometimes we talk in nature about the fact that sometimes in nature, what we think of as awful is actually beautiful because it is being true to itself. A lion or a tiger racing across the savannah to jump on a prey is not beautiful to me, and that I only see the end result. But if you look at what's happening, that is beauty. That is true beauty as they race across, because they're being true to themselves. They're being authentic to themselves. And yeah.
That makes me think about this switch we've had. It started with The Sopranos, and then it's moved on, which we've kind of sided with the antagonist in a lot of our dramas. Yeah. And the idea, though, what Kathy's talking about is they are being true to themselves, so we see the beauty in what it is they're fighting for, and that, in and of itself, if you're talking from a character point of view, is beautiful. Yeah.
Does that help you?
If they have a follow-up question, feel free to put it into chat. But until then, I'm gonna move on to the next thing. I'm curious about how this movement and energy work begins to translate into scene work.
Kathy, I want you to take the lead on this one.
Okay. I think if you are working in a class or in a rehearsal and your teacher has been using Chekhov technique to help you, then you begin from the idea of ease. And we would move through perhaps an exercise to find ease in the body, the lightness perhaps that comes with that. And then when you begin to rehearse, you can side coach the student to say, remember the feeling of ease. What is happening in your body right now? What is the sensation? Go back to the feeling of ease. I think when students get so caught up in everything they forget and they bring tension into the body. And when you are coaching scene work or directing a scene, you have to keep reminding the student, the young actor, go back to that feeling of ease, find it in the body so that they can then not have that tension when they are rehearsing, when they are working. I think it's difficult. I think feeling of ease, the four brothers, is hard sometimes for young actors to really comprehend. They don't know how to translate from the classroom to the rehearsal. And as Chekhov says, repetition is the growing power. So we constantly remind them and we constantly work with them. Any of that resonate, Susan?
Yeah, and I would argue that, not argue, I would say that when you get all of the points across, all you have to say, which is really one of the things that I love most about the Chekhov technique, is you go, hi, person, why don't you work on a feeling of ease? You know, why don't you explore the feeling of ease?
Yeah.
And I've noticed that my actors go, absolutely. When you've explored what the feeling of ease is on your personal, you know, exploration, and then you go back and you go in the rehearsal process, they understand. Absolutely. It's a common language. It's a common denominator, if you will. I'm a math person. Sorry. It's a shorthand of going, find a feeling of ease. And they go, absolutely. Absolutely. Repetition is the growing power. Absolutely.
Okay, wonderful. Next question is, what struggles that an actor faces in their growth could moving through the four brothers help most?
Michael Chekhov says that every great piece of art has these four things.
Yeah.
Feeling of form, feeling of ease, feeling of form, feeling of beauty, feeling of wholeness. A beginning artist, understanding these four feelings will inherently give them the understanding of how to create art. I feel that focusing on these four qualities, the feeling of ease, feeling of form, feeling of beauty, feeling of wholeness, and if they truly understand what it feels like in their body and with their ensemble, will create art in and of itself.
I think the struggle, I mean, if you want to go specifically to the struggle that the questioner phrased, I think one of the struggles that I see very often is the tension that actors bring into the rehearsal space. Young students bring that tension in because they want to do it right. They want to get it right. They want to be, quote, good. And I think when you concentrate on the four brothers, you can really help people let go of that tension and that feeling of judgment that comes sometimes. And it's that editor in our head that we have to get rid of. I think the four brothers really, really helps with that. And as Susan and I said now, I don't know how many times already, repetition is the growing power. And when we constantly work on the four brothers, not only in our own exploration, but let's say in a class, or if we begin a rehearsal that way, I think you really do help the young actor who sometimes struggles with tension and that sort of prejudgment thing. I think you can help them release that.
Oh, Susan, you're muted. Sorry.
I think that the four brothers are specific and also open enough that it gives the actors a direction, like the ease, the form, the beauty, the wholeness, instead of just saying be better, you know. It's right. No, it's true though. It gives them an opportunity to focus on one aspect of what they're doing at a time in order to create the better whole picture, which is what Kathy was talking about. Yeah.
Fabulous. Great. Okay, so this one is actually a two-parter, so it's a little long, so I'm just going to take my time here. When going through the brothers, I noticed that my movements seemed similar. Should there be a distinct difference between the movements, or because they are symbiotic with one another, are the movements naturally similar? Follow-up question, is this an exercise you would use at the start of rehearsal as a warm-up?
Okay.
That's it.
Let's start with the follow-up first. The quintessential way that I have been taught with our founding director, Mark Monday, is acting with balls, tossing balls, feeling of form, feeling of ease, feeling of beauty, feeling of the whole. We cannot do that right now because we can't toss balls. We can't. The feeling of the whole, especially with him, with the balls, with tossing of, and when I mean tossing the balls, I mean actually tossing balls in a circle with each other. So there's no quintessential way of doing this. I think we're all trying to figure out what we're doing as we move along. Jordan, do you mind going over the first question again?
Yeah.
Just so I can remember.
Absolutely. So when going through the brothers, I noticed that my movements seemed similar. Should there be a distinct difference?
So, sure. Because they all are with each other. That's the great thing about it. I think if you have the feeling of form, you can build on that and have the feeling of ease. You can have the feeling of beauty. You can have the feeling of the wholeness. They're all there. I think it's important to look at them individually. If form, here we go, boo, boo, boo. But, oh, how can I have ease in this? Great, yeah, sure. I think that is a very important part of the process, because what Michael Chekhov says is that you have these four things together create a beautiful piece of art. But I think it's equally as important to go in your brain, go, I am working on form. I'm working on the form. And then you go, because we're human, we go, oh, wait, that was really beautiful. I had a lot of ease in that moment. Absolutely. So that when you come to the feeling of the entirety of wholeness, you're working on yourself, you're working on your relation to space, you're working on relation to outside of where you are, you're working on everything to create this beautiful artistic creator. Kathy.
I think if I understand, I thought that was an excellent explanation. I think also one of the parts of the question might have been, is it okay if our movements are similar? I remember working with David Zinder once, who's an Israeli teacher in Chekhov, and David kept saying to me, Kathy, you always start from the right.
Yes.
Okay, all right. Good reminder that I have the left side of my body too. And so sometimes our movements, we have to remember to honor all six directions. And within that, everything Susan said is true.
Fabulous, great. Okay, next question. Does this tie into a way as the actor to move toward that larger than life, yet still based in authentic emotion, artistic creation, or stage presence?
Larger than life. The idea, I don't know who posed this question, the idea of, I don't know if you were in the
session yesterday. We talked about on Monday. Go ahead, Susan.
No, it's okay. I thought my computer messed up. They talked about on Monday about radiating and receiving, and I think that this is everything that has to do with it. Radiating and receiving, which is really funny when I, Jordan can probably tell you, I feverishly was typing because I typed it and then Kathy said it. And I was like, yes. It's a reflexive situation. It's like breathing. The radiating and receiving, sending out our energy is from all six directions everywhere in our body, and then receiving what is being given to us is part of the process. It's everything. Kathy, do you want to expand on that a little bit?
Simon Callow has written, the wonderful British actor, has written the foreword in the newest edition of To the Actor, which isn't that new anymore, I guess. But in that edition, he's written a foreword, and he says, in one part, he says, being on stage is, we don't want to see a snapshot on stage. We don't want to see a photograph. What we want to see, something which is enlarged so that we can relate to that, so we can respond to that. And so I think, yes, the Four Brothers helps us because we understand the range of our body and what we can feel, because the Four Brothers really teaches us how to feel and to understand those sensations that give us the feelings. And so I think they naturally go into that extension, that larger than life that we want to put on the stage.
Okay, great. All right, I'll move on to the next one. Do we focus on the feeling of ease always, ideally? Do we do this for the longevity of a performance? Do we do this to protect ourselves in a mental, physical bodies?
Yes. Yes. I mean, I think that the feeling of ease gives us an opportunity to be open and available to receiving to what's happening. Sure, we may be dealing with characters who have a great amount of tension. We can still find a way to create the tension while remaining open and finding the ease, because if we shut off our body, we shut off our receivers. So to be able to create the illusion of tension while still remaining open to, I am going to receive what you give me, is key to creating the story, to keeping it going. I think a lot of that has to do with understanding your own body. What is the limit that I can take this? But I think a great deal of it has to do with understanding sensation. Michael Chekhov talks about that greatly. Understanding sensation in the body. We don't have to force ourselves into tension to create the illusion of tension or real or authenticity. We have to allow ourselves to have this experience to understand what the sensation feels like in order to give an authentic performance. Kathy, anything?
I agree with that. And I think also, do we need to have the feeling of ease throughout the performance? Yes, and because repetition is the growing power, and the more we try and receive and get that feeling of ease in the body, understand that sensation, we don't think about it anymore. It's not like halfway through the performance I'm saying to myself, oh, I got to get that. Where's that feeling of ease?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. It's simply there because we've worked on it enough. We've rehearsed it enough, and it is simply there. We don't think about it anymore. We simply allow it to be there. And I think that's a good word to remember, is allowing it to be there. We don't force it to be there. We simply allow it to be there. And we are able to go on.
Great. Let me know if this question is building off of what you guys just said, or if it's just addressing what you've already addressed, but I thought it was interesting. My question is if either of you consider form to be the opposite of ease.
No. Kathy says no.
Susan says no. Form is a... it's a place and space. It's not a forcedness. It's an agreeance. It's a fluid place with space. It's an allowance. An agreement. I'm trying to find the right word.
Agreement?
in agreement with space. So that it's not a fight. We're not fighting for space. We're melding with it. We're becoming part of it. And I think that if you think about form as something that is in opposition to space, then you're creating a tension and blocking an opportunity for sensation. If I am in agreement with space and I go, I'm going to do this, but it's, I feel full formed, but I feel everything around me, thinking about the six directions, I want to feel, if I think about an opposition here, I'm thinking about my fingers. If I'm thinking about my place in space, I'm thinking about here, 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 and here. And that creates a full sensation.
Okay, great. One second. A request from our very own James. One of the things we should perhaps mention is that all tenets of the technique overlap and inspire each other.
Oh,
for example, feeling a form connect to the concept of imaginary body.
Oh, yeah. Everything. One of the greatest things about this technique, here, inspired acting.
Yes.
And all of these things that we are saying come out here, and they all help each other. It's not like I'm working on the feeling of form. Oh, I'm working on the feeling of ease. I'm working on imaginary body. It's everything that helps each other. So you might be working on imaginary body and you go, oh, the feeling of form is very prevalent to me right now. Let me explore that. And that is valid. Absolutely. Yeah. Kathy, I see you nodding. Oh,
and thank you, James.
Yeah, thank you, Jim.
Thank you.
Okay. I think we have time for just one more question here. I have found in utilizing the Chekhov tools, sisters, brothers, that I can find a great emotion in a piece of text. But when I take the full body movement away, it's hard to translate the same feeling. How can we translate using that full body movement to a straight scene or stage without losing the physicality?
I think repetition is the growing power. I think there was a... Kathy, you've got to tell me, there was an absurd amount of number that Chekhov said we had to do something.
Oh, 500 times.
It was ridiculous. It was like, yeah. you got to do it. Repetition is the growing power. And here's the thing, you're not trying to recreate what happened in that moment that you had that thing. What I've seen and what I've witnessed and just what I've learned is that actors who recreate or do repetition is the growing power, when they take and they strip away the physicality, what comes out is so authentic, and it may be different than what you did when you were doing the physical work, but it doesn't mean that it's less effective. It is still there. It is still there within you. We're not trying to recreate something that we did in the rehearsal process. We're trying to take the tools that we had in the rehearsal process and use them in the performance. And so whatever comes out in the performance is the thing. It's authentic. It's the thing we were working towards.
It's the result of what we have done in the rehearsal process.
That's right.
And so while it may be very large in the rehearsal process, what comes out in the performance is this internal magnification of what we were doing. It doesn't have to be here, because what comes out is just as real.
Right.
Excellent. Well, I think I've reached the end of my cue question, which is perfect timing because it is 5:02.
What's that means right now?
Thank you, Jordan. Thank you, Susan.
Thank you, Jordan.
Yeah, absolutely.
And thank you all. We will see you on Friday.
Yeah, see you Friday, guys. I'm going to set up my audio again so
lovely
that you
to meet you.
Can have some lovely music to.
We'll stick around if you want to talk to us for a minute. Yeah. Jim.
Bye.
Hello, is this Susan?
Yes.
Yeah, I was the one who asked a little bit about the painful part of the process, that there's a little bit of residual pain that just remains after every process, after getting into character or making sure that I use the four brothers. There is something there. I'm not really sure what it's called in words, but there is something, and the feeling might be negative at times. I've learned to just go through it and to learn from it. And there's a part of me that just observes myself going through it and observes other people, even in a tragic situation or God forbid, a traumatic situation. Although I might be affected by it, but there's still a part of me that looks at it and tries to figure out, saying that maybe someday I'll use it in a scene or something. But do you think this is healthy, or do you think this is something that I can work on in order not to have any residual negative emotions that can turn out after any actor work or actor preparation?
Kathy, can I defer to you on this one?
Yeah, I'm not sure I understand totally what you're saying. But I think if you're using your own experience, then that would be the opposite of what Chekhov would say that we want to use. Yes, we have our own experiences. They're all here in our bodies. We can't get away from that. But we don't draw upon those experiences specifically, remembering the death of our dog or whatever it might be. We don't want to do that. We want to use our imaginations. And that takes away any residual pain in our work. If we use the four brothers and we understand the sensation in our body, of the feeling of ease, the feeling of form, beauty in the whole, then if we work from those precepts instead of our own personal experience, I think the pain that you're talking about, if I understand the question, really doesn't have to be there at all.
And this ties in really nicely to what we're doing on Friday, which is the next level of the technique, which is imagination concentration. So we're going to be talking about, exactly what you just described, is how we use imagination as opposed to engaging in some kind of emotional recall approach. It's different. It's very different.
Yes. Yes. Thank you. Thank you. And this works on maybe it's something personal, and maybe other performers don't go through that, but I'm talking about pain or emptiness that happens. Like, I feel like I'm void after I've gone through this imagination. I feel like I'm overworked or overburnt, maybe, if this is the right adjective. It may be a very personal thing and it doesn't apply to other people. I just wanted to throw that out there and maybe see how it can be worked out.
It sounds like feeling of ease is something that's really necessary, going to be a very necessary thing in your work. And maybe of the four brothers, when you're working through them, start with ease.
Okay.
And that will certainly help, because, you know, the tension is going to certainly feed into that. Sorry, I jumped in, Susan and Kathy.
No, you got it.
Yeah.
Love you, brother. No, you know, we carry residual things in our body. It's muscle memory. And I think that one of the things we have to do as artists is what Jim is saying, is go, okay, this is my life, but how can I create art and authentically, you know? And I think one of the things that Chekhov gives us is the opportunity to go from the ground up and go, okay, I'm going to start with something really simple, really succinct, and I'm going to work with a feeling of ease.
And maybe read Path of the Actor, because he talks about this.
That's right.
Sorry, Susan.
No, go.
He talks about this. I mean, the whole reason this technique exists is because of Chekhov's own experiences as an actor, you know, and becoming an alcoholic, and the pain that he was dredging up night after night on stage was just eating him alive. And so he decided that he had to figure out a different approach that was going to save him.
Yeah.
So to be continued.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you all. Thank you very much.
All right, fabulous. I'm going to keep playing the music. Everybody can leave at their own leisure. Thank you all for joining again.
Go watch The Governor.
Oh, yeah, me too. All right. Bye, everybody.
Bye, Susan. Bye, Kathy. Bye, everybody.
Bye, everybody. Have a good day. Take care.